Hello lovelies and welcome back to another video. It might be weird that there's like this white thing poking out of my head. I'm just gonna go with it. Am I the only one who's ever felt pressure to try and find the perfect gift for that special someone in your life? And then you can relate. I've accumulated gift ideas to hopefully make your life easier. I didn't count how many ideas I had, but I have like 100 or something pictures to show you. All these pictures I found on Pinterest to make these DIYs. It's really simple. Just type in the idea, for example, coaster DIY. That was the way that I found all these pictures. So I'm sorry for not giving the credit to each and every one of the creators, but I figured these pictures are for references only. You can gain inspiration from them. I tried to find gift ideas that would be personalizable. I tried to find gift ideas that would be personalized for whoever you want to make them. It could be something that's already pre-made and that you simply add details to, or it could be something that you make from scratch. Also, most of them are kind of like last minute gift ideas too, so. And you don't have to make them. You can totally buy whatever I'm showing you. Or you can go on Etsy and find a creator that made the thing in question. So it's not handmade by you, but it is handmade by someone. Without further ado, my first idea was canvas bags. You can embroider on them, you can paint on them, you can transfer pictures onto canvas. As long as the piece of canvas is 100% cotton, you could also tie-dye it. So all of those kind of ideas where you personalize a bag that's pre-made, or you can make it yourself if you know how to sew by embroidering something on it. That's a really nice and quick way to make something personalized. Like even just something like this is so simple. You can basically apply this idea to anything. It can be a hat, it can be like a sweater, a t-shirt, it can be a small little camisole. Basically anything, and it's great for guys or girls. You can incorporate your initials. I remember once, I think I read a story, I really don't remember, but the person, oh, it's Gossip Girl, isn't it? Where she would like embroider something in the sleeve for her boyfriend. I think it was Blair who did that. Oh wow, I have the worst memory. I have no idea. But you get what I'm trying to say. Like, you can make it really personalized for your boyfriend or your significant other. And it's so easy. It takes like maybe half an hour if you don't want to make like a huge design. Now, if you have the possibility to go to a thrift store and you find something that you know someone would love, don't buy something new and personalize it necessarily. You can buy something old, something vintage. So for example, you can tie-dye a sweater for your, like, you know, your significant other. If they love a show, or they love a video game, or they love a specific brand. If you want to bleach something that's already colored, a bottle of bleach is what? No more than $5. And sweaters nowadays in thrift stores vary from $10 to $15. So for like $25-ish.
Both logic and math are taking a serious hit today.
Coasters are also a great idea. You can make them from a ton of different types of materials. You can sew them, you can crochet them, you can cut them out of cork. You can also buy some that are pre-made and personalize them. If you want to make something that's more of a kit gift, you can add coasters to a mug. Ooh, that's hot. What I personally did once is I bought a bunch of mugs that were just plain white, and I bought Sharpies. And it kind of became this activity to do during Christmas Day, where I instructed everyone to just use Sharpies, decorate their mugs however they wanted them to be decorated, and then you cook the mugs in the oven. I don't quite remember the steps. You can Google it. It's very easy. And it was so much fun. Everyone got exactly what they wanted because they were the one designing their own mugs. It ended up being quality time spent together with family and loved ones. It's just an overall really fun thing to look back on. Every textile kitchen accessory is also a great DIY gift. They are a little more on the technical side. I'm talking about aprons. I'm talking about oven mitts. I don't know if you've noticed, but a lot of people have really ugly ones. Once you buy towels, you don't ever buy them again. At least not me, and not my family, and not my friends. They buy one kit at the beginning of their like adulthood at life, and then that's it. Pot holders are another great idea. And you can make that into a gift, you know, kit as well. So you just add some wooden spoons and other accessories that the person needs, and then it becomes this cute little personalized gift again. Tablecloths are a great thing to personalize. Again, you can embroider them. Again, you can tie-dye it. Again, you can add little cute fancy fringes on the edges. and then it becomes personalized. It doesn't have to be complicated. More oriented towards someone's personal style for their house or something like that. You can personalize cushions, you can add tassels, do all the other personalizations I've already suggested. I'm not gonna say them again. It takes a minimum amount of fabric and it's just a really nice gift to give. Placemats are really fun too to personalize. You can use so many different fabrics. You can also use so many different techniques. You can crochet, you can sew, you can simply cut out of corkboard again, kind of like the same ideas as the coasters, just in a bigger size basically. This is not sewing related, but if you want to make a beeswax wrapping, apparently those are really easy to do. I've seen how to make them online. I've never made them myself, but you can make them so cute, so personalized, fold them up in a really neat way, and then when you give it, it's just a really cute gift. Yeah. I've seen a lot of those macrame plant hangers that are still really popular. You can make those very easily. That can also be a really fun idea. If the person you're giving a gift to has a pet, you can make pet collars for cats or dogs. I'm thinking mostly you can make a leash. You could buy a leash that's already pre-made with all the little metal accessories. If it's cotton, then you could tie-dye it. Again, you could embroider something on it. You can make those really cute little scarves or bandanas that cats and dogs usually have once they go to the toileter. Is that what it's called? You know, the person who like washes your cat and dog and clips their toenails and stuff? Toileter? I feel like that's wrong. But yeah. Anything that's pet related can be really cute. If you have little scraps of leather, you can make these really adorable little bookmarks that are like in a heart shape and they go in the corner of the pages. Those are so cute. Or again, you can use those leather scraps for card organizers. Something else you could do is those little card holders. I personally don't really use my wallet anymore. I only carry 2 to 3 cards around with me. So a little card holder is perfect. It doesn't take up too much space. It can fit in one's pocket. Also really inexpensive, especially if you already have some leather laying around. And if you don't, you can buy some at the dollar store. They have like these leather square pieces exactly for that purpose, to make some smaller DIYs. And that's perfect. It's inexpensive. I think it's around $3 usually. Really easy. You can buy felt and do a bunch of project with it. You can do ornaments, which are so cute. When I saw those online, I was so sad that I don't have a Christmas tree this year, because honestly, those would have been so cute. Like, I have these little, tiny little snowflakes that you can see behind me, but it's just, those ornaments are so cute. You can always use felt for a bunch of other projects, like cord organizers or little coin purses. Pouches, you know what I'm talking about? Those are always really cute and they can be really easy to make if you keep them nice and small. Don't need a sewing machine, you can sew those by hand. Let's not forget masks. Everybody needs masks now. Great gift for anyone. Personalizable to the maximum. Fabric scraps can also be used to make a lot of like smaller projects. So for example, sleeping masks are a really cute idea. We can also add a scrunchie that's gonna go with the kit if you wanna make a kit idea. You can add a headscarf that's gonna go with the whole look. You know those headscarves that are kind of like for the spa? So they're kind of like towel on one side and they're like this cute little fabric on the other side. So you can do those and then you can make like a cute little at-home spa gift kit. I think that would be really cute. You should do that. Okay, by now it's not really for scrap fabrics, you need a little more fabric, but if you have enough fabric to also make a bag and then you can put everything in it. I saw a bunch of pictures that were really cute and it was like this whole, all those things all together, it was really cute. Slippers are also a really cute idea. I personally used to have slippers for my grandmother when I was younger and it was so cute. You can buy some that are pre-made that are just kind of neutral and you can personalize them, or you can just make some from scrap, from felt or from other fabric that's kind of a little stiffer, just to add a nice stiffness to the framing of the slipper. Bibs are also a great way to go. You can make them into a scarf shape or you can make them the typical round shape. It's a pretty easy sewing project and you can personalize it to whatever baby you're giving it to. So if it's your niece or your nephew, you can personalize it. You can embroider it again. I'm really going strong on that embroidery idea. You can use scrap fabrics for the most part because it's not a huge piece of fabric that you have to use to create them, so it's a pretty inexpensive gift as well. I personally love having a transparent case on my cell phone and personalizing it to whatever I want. I used to add dry flowers in the back here, and then it would kind of create this decorative detail to the case. As long as they're transparent, you can paint them, you can add pictures, you can add decorative tape or dried flowers. Really simple, really fun. Still thinking of the case idea, but for your computer this time. It's a really great unisex gift. You can buy some pretty inexpensive ones on Amazon, but I personally think that it's such a simple thing to sew. It's a really good basic project where you learn a lot. It's just a great gift. That's not the easiest thing to create, but it is a nice challenge for you, and the end product, I'm sure, is gonna please the other person. Now that a lot of us are working from home, I've thought that mouse pads would be a really great gift idea this year. You can also go on those personalized gift websites and you can input a picture and then they print it out onto a mouse pad or anything else, a mug or whatever you want to give, and then that becomes the gift and it's personalized. Fabric bins I think are so cute. I have some in my apartment and I use them to just put away all my cords, all my miscellaneous items that I don't exactly know where to put. I just put them in those. It just adds a nice pop of color to any environment. And if you understand like the geometry of how to make things from 2D to 3D, then boxes are really easy. But yeah, I personally think fabric bins are fun and cute and DIYable and personalizable. I think those are very important words in this video. Just because you think someone has everything doesn't mean they actually do. And that's usually the person that you want to personalize a gift to, because they can usually kind of buy everything they want themselves, but they can't buy a personalized gift from you, the person who loves them. So, I have figured out the life hack of how to give gifts to someone who has everything. I am amazing. I am the smartest. Subscribe to my channel. Like this video. Thank you. I don't know how to go on from this trail of thought, so I'm just gonna... Okay, I think that's enough ideas. Just try and remember that gift giving is supposed to be fun. So don't put too much pressure on yourself, especially this year. Just keep it nice, keep it simple. That's what I'll try to do this Christmas time. Stay at home and breathe and DIY stuff. Can't really do much more in this pandemic. But yeah, I hope some of these ideas gave you inspiration. If you don't pick any of them, but you did have more ideas, don't hesitate to leave them down below. I'm sure some other people would enjoy reading them. On that note, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have amazing holidays. 2020 is almost over. The pandemic is not. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys. Those are the ways in which I suggest you gift give this year. It's just so much more simple. Besides, who wants to go shopping now with the pandemic and everything? Ew. No thank you. Although, I do miss thrift stores. But even thrift stores now, you can go online. You can just buy whatever you want online. On eBay, on Poshmark, on ThredUp, Marketplace, on Facebook, Kijiji. You can order things online. Stay safe, guys. Okay, that's enough. I'm really done rambling.